Faith without action is dead. If you have faith, but you do not put this faith into exercise, Number one, is reading our Bible. It's the first thing. It's through reading our Bible, which is our manual. You keep on reading. If you read, you will find good things that it is said in your house. For example, if you read the Bible and you hear the words of your God, if in the book of Luke, that if you have a small faith, as Master said, you can tell this tree to move from here to there, and it will happen. When you read and find that in the Bible, and it is saying, if you have that faith, and if you put that faith in your next, you will be able to tell this mountain tree to move from here and go to the city, that it will happen. So that fills you with a lot of, I would say, faith. Because if really, if I can do this, don't you think that is good enough faith? It's yes. So if you read the Bible and tell you those things, you know, if I do this, it will happen like this. That is good for you. So the first thing is that we must be able to read our Bible. It will give us the steps to do. It will tell us what to do. And if you do, and what you are doing, and hoping, and it has been passed, and you are faith through which you are standing what you are, which what something that has happened, and you believe. Now, this is faith, which you can always keep on doing. The second thing that we need is praying to God. Praying to God. Praying to God. If you look, you are no reason not to praise God. Not once, but all the times, so that our faith grows in us. The believing in God is another one. And believing in God, look, you look at Luke chapter 7. This is a man who has a child, and he's telling God, please heal my child. God is telling him, Jesus is telling him, he was not able to get to his centurion's house. But the centurion is telling him, I am a soldier, I have people that I command, and if I tell them to do this, they will do. If I tell them to do this, they will do. So you don't have to come. Just send a word and it's and what you send a word, it will happen. But Jesus saw what kind of faith this man had. You don't have to be there. And Jesus did what the centurion wanted. His child was there. So, what if you believe in God, you are able to do what God can do, and to command him to do that which he can do. He said that faith will be nice. Faith will be nice. You have to believe in God. Helping the needy is another one. Helping the needy. When you help your people who need your help, if you are helping them, your faith increases through that. Look, you will look at James chapter 1, chapter 2, verse 1. You look at it. God is saying, help me. When you help them, you're helping them by faith. But when you help, you see people who are benefited out of you. There are many more. But if we do these with the few that I've mentioned, there's no reason why our faith will not grow. There's no reason why our faith will not increase in us, and we'll be able to keep on believing in God and trusting in God. Increase our faith. in what thing you have to remember God, increase your faith, so that your faith will fail in action. But God didn't give you because he was one of your mind. If my God has anything that was spoken that does not, it's not spoken before your children, I ask you what your next is. But what that means when we have spoken that is helping your children, Father, we need to listen so that they can progress in the way. We thank you because we know that you're going to be with us. From today, next Sunday, we will meet and we shall bless you tomorrow. I want to pray for the prayer that we brought before you. We have already gone to give you thanks because you were with him when you were away from this church. You gave him good stay at home. You also gave him good travel back. Thank you because you see the many aspects happening in the world. But God, you are able to bring him up to us, and we thank you, my God. Thank you too, because he has planned to travel to help tomorrow for Mwiti. God, you want to put a standard before you, so that the Father shall be the driver of the service. That God shall take him separate and bring him back separate and shall worship him with your God. Thank you, because you are good.